The small Northern Irish village of Clogmills in Ballymena, surrounded by farms and named after its old linen mill, is a beautiful setting for a country walk. Zoe and Lucy are twin sisters who support each other in fighting a crippling condition which affects them both.
We're so very glad that we have each other to go through this together, because there's only two other sets of twins in the world. Everybody else is kind of going through it solo, but I have a co-pilot. I don't honestly know what I would do without her. We do everything together and I wouldn't have it any other way.
Both sisters have a crippling and potentially lethal genetic condition called fibrodysplasia ossifans progressiva, which causes their flesh and muscle to turn to bone whenever they have an injury.
FOP is a condition where if you fall or bump your muscles, ligaments, tendons, joints, they turn to bone.
The long-term effects of FOP can impact life expectancy, especially if it attacks the respiratory system.
Most people with FOP, not to be morbid or anything, but would die of breathing complications because of the extra bone that has grown around, like, the rib cage area.
When most people suffer a bump or a bruise, the body naturally mends the damaged tissue. But with FOP, any knock or bump gradually forms bone in the affected area, fusing the joints together and making sufferers as rigid as human statues.
It can sometimes be very quick. Sometimes it could be 6 months down the line, and then you're thinking, oh, well, I didn't hurt myself. But then when you think back, you have.
This is a critical period for the twins, who've been taking part in tests for a possible new treatment for FOP, which could be a major medical breakthrough for sufferers everywhere. When Zoe and Lucy were first diagnosed with FOP, they were 8 years old, and the family moved from Yorkshire to Ballymena.
We had a normal childhood. We had bikes and rollerblades and scooters, and we did everything. We just had to be careful.
This happy time was to come to an abrupt halt when Zoe broke her arm.
I broke it above the elbow and had it put in a cast, and then whenever the doctors and stuff took off the cast, it was bent and they couldn't straighten it. So they operated twice and I suppose made matters worse.
As the twins grew up, their FOP symptoms became more serious.
Going through teenage years were definitely difficult. I was in a wheelchair and nobody else was. Maybe when I was about 14, 15, I started to limp.
Today, of the two sisters, Zoe's symptoms are more severe.
I can't reach either a hand up to my mouth. Both arms are fused and my left leg is also fused. Getting about day to day is extremely difficult, but I don't know, somehow I just seem to just get on with it.
Refusing to let their condition run their lives, both sisters have partners. Zoe married Mike after meeting him 6 years ago.
He knew about FOP, but maybe not to the great extent maybe that it could have kind of got to.
I knew the rough outline of it, basically. I can't really remember ever thinking it was going to be that much of a problem.
I think we're the perfect team.
Lucy, meanwhile, has teamed up with Michael.
Because whenever we first met up, I noticed she had a wee bit of a limp, yeah. But that was the only thing I noticed. It didn't put me off or anything like that there.
Always fighting their condition, the twins have been taking part in a clinical trial in London. They're testing a drug which could prevent the creation of bone in their bodies.
We come here every 3 months to get scans, see how it's progressing, if it's getting better or if it's getting worse, and really to see if the drug is working.
Lucy has recently had a flare-up in her stomach. Today's MRI scan will reveal if the drug has prevented the formation of any new bone. The scans will be assessed by specialists at the hospital, led by consultant Dr. Richard Keane.
In FOP about 10 years ago, the gene for this condition was discovered, and this has led to basically great understanding about how FOP is caused, why flare-ups seem to happen, and understanding the genetics has led people to look at developing new drugs.
The twins are naturally anxious about the results, because if the drugs stop cartilage turning into bone, then operations to restore ossified joints will be possible.
Hi. Just looking at your scan, we're particularly now focusing on the front end of your stomach, which is where you have the flare-up and where the muscles were really inflamed. And in a lot of people, that would start to turn into bone. But because we're not seeing any whiteness that reflects bone, we are really happy that that flare-up over the last sort of, you know, 3 months has fully resolved. It's amazing. It's amazing, really. Because beforehand there was an awful lot of swelling in those muscles, and now
it's... I honestly thought there would be something.
Yeah. So hopefully you're not going to get any more flare-ups.
And it continues.
The wider implication of the research is that this could lead to a cure for FOP.
As we pool the results from other people having the trials throughout the world, we'll get enough information that will then hopefully prove that we've got a cure for the condition.
It's exciting, but isn't this being a part of
something? It's really exciting. I've been
something.
Part of it now for nearly four years.
Yeah.
As Lucy's results are so good, naturally, this should also be the case for Zoe.
I feel that we're getting somewhere.
Slowly, and but surely.
Yeah. And it's exciting. Gives us hope.
This could mean everything for Zoe and Lucy and other FOP sufferers around the world. If their condition is proved to be reversible, they could go into remission.